In the Supreme Court today, Mr. Justice Jack did not accept Isaac Maracha was genuinely remorseful. He said Maracha had been indifferent to the rising and irrecoverable legal costs of his actions during the legal proceedings. The judge points out the Maracha brothers continued to fight for their innocence until the 11th of November 2015, when the Privy Council refused their appeal. He said Maracha continues to minimise his offending. Mr. Justice Jack said he was acutely aware that people from all walks of life in Gibraltar have suffered from the fraud of the Maracha brothers. These included people in modest circumstances who saved money for many years to raise a deposit for a property purchase. Some had entire life savings wiped out when Maracha & Co. went down, said the judge. In a frank passage in his 15-page judgment, Mr. Justice Jack says many of the Maracha's victims will consider that 2 years and 4 months imprisonment is grossly inadequate punishment for the misery Isaac Maracha and his brothers inflicted on them. But he said the law is clear. Once Isaac Maracha had served 2 years and 4 months, a third of his sentence, he was entitled to be considered for parole. The sole question, said the judge, was that of risk assessment. While Maracha's lack of remorse means he would have no scruple carrying out further frauds, the reality is that he'll have little opportunity to do that, as he's well known locally, said the judge. Interestingly, until today, Isaac Maracha had not been debarred in either Gibraltar or England, meaning he could have described himself as a non-practicing barrister. The matter was resolved when Maracha voluntarily wrote to both associations this morning, accepting that he can no longer practice as a lawyer. Mr. Maracha declined to comment to GBC.